In this section, you'll take a look at different types of pesticide application equipment. Equipment can range from very simple to very complex. Some equipment is specialized for applying only certain formulations, such as granules or dusts. Even for one formulation type, like liquids, there may be several different types of equipment available depending on the type of application, such as in buildings or residences, to crops, in water, or to soil, or whether they are spot treatments or broadcast treatments over a larger area. Before you choose your equipment, determine which pesticide formulation you'll be using and to what kind of site you'll be applying the product. Then, make sure that the equipment you use is suited to the location and conditions of the treatment site. Choose equipment that is comfortable to use and easy to calibrate. Liquid application equipment usually consists of a tank for mixing and holding the pesticide, a system of pipes or hoses that move a pesticide from the tank to the nozzle, a pump that creates pressure to move the liquid, one or more nozzles that break the spray into droplets, and on some equipment, a wand that aims the nozzle at the target. Larger applicators may have pressure regulators, fans, filter screens, control valves, booms, agitators, or other devices to improve pesticide mixing and application. Most spray equipment can apply most types of liquid pesticides, but don't use an herbicide sprayer for any other pesticide types. This is because the sprayer in all of its parts could retain residues that may damage desirable plants, even after the equipment is thoroughly cleaned after each use. It's best to have a separate sprayer just for herbicide use. You should also use separate sprayers for herbicides with different modes of action. For example, broad spectrum and more selective herbicides, so that you can avoid any unintended consequences on plants that are treated. The tank is the part of the sprayer that holds the pesticide mixture. It should be corrosion and rust resistant to protect it from reacting with corrosive pesticides. Tanks are usually made from metal, fiberglass, or thermoplastic materials such as polyethylene and polypropylene. Tanks should have a large opening to make them easy to fill and clean, and a tight-fitting cover to prevent spilling. When filling, leave an air gap to prevent contaminated water from siphoning back into the fill hose. Most liquid sprayers have a hand or motor-operated pump that moves the pesticide from the tank to the nozzles. The pump must generate enough pressure to propel the spray from the nozzles to the target. The pump you need depends upon the pesticide formulation you are using and the volume and pressure needed to apply the pesticide. For compressed air and backpack sprayers, pressure in these pumps is generated by moving a lever up and down. Nozzles are one of the most important parts of a sprayer. They affect the application rate and determine the droplet size and spray pattern. There are many different types of nozzles available, and the choice of which one to use depends on the application equipment and treatment situation. It is important to carefully select nozzles based on the type of material the nozzle is made of, the style of nozzle, and the orifice size. If nozzles aren't properly selected and maintained, application uniformity is compromised, and pest control will be inconsistent at best. All nozzles are subject to wear, regardless of the type or material they are made from. To ensure uniform wear when using multiple nozzles on a single piece of equipment, be sure they are all made from the same material. The nozzle design, the pesticide being applied, and the pressure at which the pesticide is applied all contribute to the deterioration of a nozzle. As a nozzle wears, the volume and pattern of its spray changes and affects the quality of application. Replace nozzles when they vary from each other by more than 10%. If you are using a wand that only has one nozzle, replace it when it varies by more than 10% from the manufacturer's specs. Manufacturers produce nozzles from brass, stainless steel, aluminum and nickel copper alloy, plastic, and tungsten carbide and ceramic. Brass nozzles are somewhat inexpensive but wear quickly from abrasion. They're acceptable for use if you replace them frequently and do not use abrasive sprays like wettable powder formulations. Stainless steel nozzles are expensive, but they wear slowly, resist abrasion, and do not corrode. Aluminum and nickel copper alloy nozzles resist corrosion but are made of soft metals, making them highly susceptible to abrasion. They should be avoided unless you need a nozzle specifically resistant to corrosion. Plastic nozzles are the least expensive and resist corrosion. However, nozzles made entirely out of plastic can swell if exposed to organic solvents. Solid plastic nozzles should only be used with water-soluble pesticides. Some plastic nozzles are fitted with a stainless steel orifice insert to reduce swelling and make them more resistant to wear. Tungsten carbide and ceramic nozzles are highly resistant to corrosion and abrasion. They are often used for high pressure and abrasive sprays. Many backpack sprayers come with plastic adjustable nozzles. These often wear out rapidly. You should replace them with sturdier metal nozzles if possible. Nozzles are designed for specific types of applications. For example, nozzles made to apply herbicides in a field may be unsuitable for applying insecticides to foliage. Let's look at the various types of nozzles available. Flat spray or flat fan nozzles are the most common nozzle type attached along a boom, a pipe either connected to a vehicle or used by hand. They produce a fan-shaped pattern that has more droplets in the center part of the fan than at either edge. This allows for overlap of the spray, eliminates gaps, and gives an even pattern when multiple nozzles are used. Off-center flat spray nozzles emit a full pattern of spray to one side of the nozzle. These are used on the ends of spray booms to extend the reach of the nozzle. Even flat spray nozzles provide a uniform distribution of spray throughout the fan pattern. The spray is not overlapped. These nozzles are used to apply separate bands of pesticide. Cone nozzles are used for applying insecticides and fungicides to foliage and for post-emergent herbicides, especially when larger volumes are required to assure complete coverage. A hollow cone pattern is used for most applications, but use solid cone nozzles if you need larger droplets to reduce drift or need more volume. Solid stream or pin stream nozzles are used in high pressure hand spray guns and in low pressure crack and crevice units. They produce a single solid stream of pesticide. These nozzles are used primarily for structural pest control. Flood nozzles are used to apply large volumes of liquid under low pressure. They are mainly used for liquid fertilizers, but occasionally for pesticides. They produce a wide fan angle of up to 160 degrees. Broadcast nozzles are used as a cluster on boomless sprayers and attached at one point. These are used where you can't use a boom, but need a wide swath. Flood nozzles and broadcast nozzles can be used for vegetation control on roads in natural areas. Because the settings on adjustable nozzles can be accidentally changed, they are not recommended and should be replaced with fixed nozzles. Otherwise, a sprayer with adjustable nozzles should be calibrated with every use. It is much better to purchase two or three fixed pattern nozzles and change them out depending on the spray pattern needed. Liquid pesticide application equipment is hand-operated or mechanically powered by an electric motor or gasoline engine. Hand-operated equipment is relatively inexpensive, easy to use and maintain, and primarily used for applying pesticides to small areas or specific targets. Here are some examples. Trigger pump sprayers are simple sprayers used for insect and pathogen control on indoor plants and small home yard areas. Squeezing a trigger forces a pesticide mixture through a nozzle, producing a fine spray. Compressed air sprayers are used in many commercial and residential applications. They hold up to 5 gallons of a diluted pesticide spray mixture in a small, airtight tank. Air in the tank is compressed by using a hand pump. The liquid under pressure is forced from the tank through a hose attached to a nozzle at the end of a handheld wand. Backpack sprayers are also used in both commercial and residential applications. The tank is usually made of plastic and generally has a capacity of 3 to 5 gallons. Backpack sprayers have a hand-operated pump that forces the liquid through one or more nozzles attached to a handheld wand with a nozzle at the end. You pressurize the tank by moving a lever up and down with one hand and control the spray with the squeeze valve on the spray wand. Wick applicators are used for applying herbicides to emerged weeds in agricultural or landscape settings. They consist of a cloth, pad, rope, or wick saturated with the herbicide. The applicator wipes the pad or wick onto leaves and stems. Turf grass areas and other larger-scale pesticide application situations require powered equipment that is capable of covering a large outdoor area more quickly than handheld equipment can. The spray pump is usually driven by a self-contained motor or powered by a tractor or similar source. Powered equipment may also have hydraulic or mechanical agitators, pressure regulators, spray booms, hand spray booms, and other nozzle arrangements. Powered backpack sprayers consist of a backpack unit with a small gasoline engine that drives a pump to force pesticide through one or more nozzles. They work best for low-volume applications. Low-pressure sprayers are commonly used in agriculture, rights-of-way, and landscape applications. Tanks can hold up to 100 gallons and are mounted on a small vehicle or tractor. Many sprayers use multiple nozzles along a boom. Some types of sprayers can inject pesticides into the soil. Controlled droplet applicators, commonly known as ultra-low volume (ULV) foggers, are designed to apply small volumes of uniform-sized droplets. The pesticide doesn't go through a nozzle, but rather goes into a spinning disc where it is sprayed by centrifugal force. These applicators are used for applying contact herbicides and some insecticides. They may be handheld or mounted on a spray boom. High-pressure hydraulic sprayers are used on dense foliage and large trees or shrubs in landscapes, rights-of-way, or agricultural settings. They force a large volume of diluted pesticide through a hand spray gun or nozzles mounted on a boom. These sprayers can be mounted on a large trailer or tractor. Granules and dusts aren't mixed with water, but instead are applied dry. After application, granules are usually moved into the soil with water or cultivation. Granule applications are applied mostly with rotary or drop spreaders and may be hand-operated, mechanically driven, or engine-powered. Equipment must take into account the pellet size. Hand-operated applicators are usually strapped to the operator's chest. Granules pass through an adjustable opening at the bottom of a hopper and drop onto a spinning plate operated by a hand crank. The operator walks at a steady pace while turning the crank to get an even distribution of the granules. Disadvantages of these applicators are the inaccuracy of the application and the potential exposure of the operator to the pesticide product. There are several types of mechanically driven applicators, including wheeled rotary applicators and drop spreaders. These require accurate calibration. Wheeled rotary applicators are pushed along the ground. Your travel speed controls the swath width. As speed increases, granules are scattered more widely. Drop spreaders apply granules and pellets more precisely than rotary spreaders. Granules drop straight down and only a short distance. Rotary spreaders usually distribute particles less uniformly than drop spreaders, and drop spreaders require overlapping passes. With all of these kinds of spreaders, leave an untreated border at each end of the target site and use this border for turning. Powered granule applicators are backpack applicators powered by small gas engines. Granules are blown from the hopper through a flexible hose. The operator must try to keep the device steady while walking slowly at a constant speed. Soil drenching and soil injection are used to apply root-absorbed systemic insecticides to soil around trees and small shrubs. For drench applications, you can measure the pesticide in a bucket, dilute it, and pour it onto the soil around the base of a tree trunk. A pressurized soil injector is a better way to deliver pesticide to tree roots without runoff. For tree injections, drill small holes through the trunk. In each hole, place a tube connected to a container of pesticide. Some application devices use pressure to force the pesticide into the tree. Others are self-contained and drain slowly into the drilled holes. A drawback with tree injections is potential injury to tree trunks caused by drilling.